excuse me for reading straight from my script. Right, early in 2015, Anne contacted my school to see if we'd be involved in an exciting 3D printing project with partner schools from around Europe. This sounded really good, and I was fortunate enough then to be invited by Anne to the final meeting of a previous 3D thinking project at Leeuwarden in the Netherlands to experience the wonderful opportunities being involved in such a project as this. The students get very excited when they see the 3D printer in action, and some of them will just sit there for ages just watching the machine go in. Really weird. But we've developed a number of lesson plans, and some of them have been really successful. One in particular is the sticky situation, which I've used and I know has been used in other schools as well. Initially, the students struggled to come up with ideas, but once they got into the correct frame of mind of 3D thinking, the ideas just flowed and they couldn't wait to start building them. It was really good to see one group in particular create designs which did not work for the first time, and they persevered and they redesigned their project, and this showed great resilience. One particular example was this box that a student made, and he was really, really struggling to get the lolly sticks to fit into the slots and also to get them to line up like that. And the first one he printed, he forgot to put the slots in the top. So he had to go back and redesign that and get all those lined up. So that worked really, really well. I was really, really happy with that. And the student who was doing the designing worked really hard, and he came back in his own time to do some more work. Another project, same sticky situation. This person or this group, they were making a money box initially. Okay, and this was their first effort at it. But the pieces on the back didn't fit in properly, so they then had to go back to the drawing board and redesign that. And they then came up with a final solution, which has got a slot in the top for money to go into and 3D printed parts all the way around. So that was really, really exciting, really successful. So that was great. The funding that we've been fortunate to have from the Erasmus Plus project has enabled teachers to visit schools in other countries across Europe, which has been really good. And as a result of this funding, as I said earlier, we've now purchased at least 6 3D printers. The most exciting part of this project for me was finding out about all the things you can do with 3D printers. I thought it was just about plastic when I first started, but it's far more than that. We've seen printers printed in clay, glass, and even cookie dough, which is amazing. What next? Bricks, I suppose. Who knows? What have I gained from this project? Right, I've learned many new skills from the project, apart from the obvious one, which is to design an object in CAD and transfer that to the 3D printer. I've also gained confidence in giving presentations like this. Me being filmed, never thought it would happen, but there we go. And cascading information about this project to other people as well, I think has been really, really good. I've even delved into the depths of writing and produced an article for a magazine. Again, something I'd never thought I would do, because writing's not my forte. And I was really pleased with the response of that. That was great. As we come to the end of this project, which is a real shame, but everything has to come to an end, I think it's important now that we consolidate everything we've learned, making sure that we can implement everything into the curriculum and beyond as well. I'm hoping that teachers from other departments will embrace the technology more so. It's been really hard to encourage other people to do that, but I think time constraints and perhaps a little bit scared of the technology as well. But I'm hoping that we can start looking to integrate 3D printing into everybody's day-to-day teaching. It's been a fantastic project to be involved in. It certainly raised the profile of my DT department in school and made many people aware of the exciting opportunities that we have available for 3D printing.
So after our meeting in Valencia, we went to the head with the proposal, and he was happy for us to use some of our funding, as well as quite a lot of funding that the school had got from a sponsored walk to create the makerspace. Students that we've seen using the makerspace tend to come to lessons now with a much more independent spirit. They're sort of happy to really get stuck in. They're no longer worrying about, well, how do I do this properly? They're coming up with really creative solutions, and this is really evident with our GCSE students and our A-level students who are working even more independently than they would normally. During this project, I feel my designing skills and 3D modelling skills have really improved. I was already quite proficient in SketchUp, but delving into other bits of software has really expanded my creativity, as well as the way I would approach teaching 3D modelling with students. It's been absolutely fantastic to see what other schools have done, and looking at even small little bits of software that we wouldn't have even thought we could be using. One of the most incredible 3D prints that a student has created with us has got to be this motorbike. One of our A-level students, Hamish, designed all of this on Fusion 360, and then we printed all the parts individually. It was quite a complex build, as you can imagine. Lots of individual bits and pieces needing supports all over the place. But at the end of the day, he's created something absolutely incredible, and it's gone on to be part of his A-level portfolio.